So here we are, number 200. I made this year. It's probably 4 months old or something like that. With this guitar, I've made some pretty substantial changes by the request of my uncles. Celin particularly wanted the fingerboard on a guitar very often is one thickness to the body and then it's a little thinner once you get past the body, and he wanted one thickness throughout and a little thicker to give easier access up high, which involved changing the neck angle of the guitar quite a bit. And something I added unrelated for is more head angle to the guitar. Changing the neck angle and the head angle changes the way the guitar feels and responds, the speed of attack. And I think for the better. I'm really happy with these major changes. And one other change I made, not change, but experiment, was I went with a rosewood fingerboard on this guitar, inspired by a guitar which you and Tim will be dealing with later. There's an old Miguel Rodriguez that had a rosewood fingerboard, which is phenomenal. And I didn't tell him that you were trying to hunt him down. I wanted him to be happy, but anyway, more trades to be made. This is number 200. Before my father plays, I want to thank you all again for coming, and thank everyone involved for helping this happen. It's great. I'm one of the lucky ones that gets to do what they love.
By the way, Tim, I lost that Miguel Rodriguez.
I was here last week, and that's the phone call you didn't answer when you were in Colombia. Yeah.
You see, the gods are with me. I would like to play, since this is the last guitar we are going to be performing on, a piece that if my father was here, he would play for you, his own Cuban fantasy.
Thank you.
ask you questions.